Hello everybody. In this video, we're going to talk about the return of the International Entrepreneur Parole Rule. This is a very exciting rule specifically designed to help foreign entrepreneurs to launch their companies in the United States. In this video specifically, we're going to talk about what's been happening with the International Entrepreneur Parole Program. What is the International Entrepreneur Parole Program? I'll break it down for you in detail. How long can international entrepreneurs be paroled into the United States, and how do we actually apply for this program? What are some of the drawbacks of this program as opposed to traditional visas like the E2, the EB2 green card, and the L visa? And finally, what about spouses and children of these entrepreneurs? Can they come to the United States? Can they work? I'll talk about all this in this video, so make sure you stick to the end. So what are you waiting for? I'll see you on the other side. Hello everybody, and welcome back to our Immigration Channel. This is a place where you get the most up-to-date immigration information, immigration updates, and everything else that you need to know to make your immigration journey less stressful. My name is Jacob Sapochnik, and I'm an immigration attorney located in San Diego, California, and I help immigrants in all 50 states. If you're here for the first time, make sure to subscribe to our channel, click the notification bell so you don't miss any of our videos, and also, give us a big like so YouTube will be able to share this video with more people just like you. So let's get started and jump in and talk about the International Entrepreneur Parole Rule. This program was created during the Obama presidency and was set to start on July 14, 2017. The idea behind this program is to allow entrepreneurs and startup founders to enter the United States for a period of up to 5 years so they're able to come here and build their companies. This is specifically for founders that may not qualify for the traditional visas like the E2 or the O1 or the EB2 green card because they don't meet certain criteria. But they do have a good startup with potential for growth and expansion. And therefore, parole will be a great way for them to enter and start working right away. Remember that this program was not established as a permanent solution. It's just a temporary option to allow immigrants to come here to the United States on a temporary basis without applying for a visa at a U.S. embassy abroad or even a USCIS, simply by applying for parole to allowing them to come here and start their companies and start driving innovation from day one. But sadly, shortly after President Donald Trump took office, his administration started taking action to dismantle this program and plan to end it by issuing certain rules to postpone the implementation of this program. First, it was postponed to March 14, 2018, and later on, they issued another rule to finally terminate this program completely. And since then, the International Entrepreneur Rule remained in complete limbo, with the Trump-era Federal Register rule sitting idle, just waiting to be implemented. But this week, the Biden administration made it clear that the International Entrepreneur Rule is here to stay. In the next few minutes, I'll tell you exactly what it's about and how you can also apply for it. So what is the International Entrepreneur Parole Program all about? This rule creates an option for those entrepreneurs that may not qualify for the L visa, the E2 visa, the EB2 green card as a national interest waiver, or the EB1 green card as a person of exceptional ability. And remember that all these options, all these visas require certain things like a degree, or very high skill, or maybe a lot of money, and not everybody has that. And so this option is specifically geared for those that have a startup or about to start a startup and are ready to implement and make this a reality. And this rule was created to help those individuals. The International Entrepreneur Rule grants those individuals a permission to enter the United States on a temporary basis and stay here for up to 5 years to build their companies. Those entrepreneurs that are interested in doing this will have to show that their venture will provide a significant benefit to the United States as well. So what are the general requirements for the program? Number one, the applicant must have already established a U.S. business within the 5 years before applying for the parole. Number two, the applicant entrepreneur must hold ownership interest in the company of at least 10%. So unlike an E2 visa, for example, or an L visa as an owner that requires at least 50% or more, the entrepreneur rule requires only 10% ownership. Number three, the applicant must play an active and central role in the startup and not just be an investor. So for example, just like the E2 visa, where you have to have an active role in the company, the same thing with the international entrepreneur parole rule. You must have an active role in your company, otherwise you're not going to be eligible for this parole. Number four, the startup must receive at least $250,000 in investment from a qualified accredited investor, or at least $100,000 from a qualifying US federal grants or awards. Those entrepreneurs that can only partially satisfy these financial requirements will have to prove that the startup has the potential for rapid growth and massive job creation. So even if you don't have all the funds secure, they'll give you the opportunity to prove those other elements to qualify as well. One important thing to remember, the international entrepreneur rule can only be granted for up to 3 entrepreneurs per 1 startup. So if you guys have 5 founders, only 3 of you can qualify for this parole, and the others will have to look at other visa options that they may qualify for. So how long can entrepreneurs be actually paroled into the United States under this program? Approved entrepreneurs can be paroled for an initial period of up to 30 months with authorization to work only for their startup. So once you get a parole, you cannot just work anywhere. You have to work in that business. Very similar to what you get when you apply for an E2 visa or an L1 visa. Now, you can apply for an additional 30 months of parole if you can demonstrate the following. Number one, the business continues to operate. Number two, the entrepreneur retains at least 5% of the ownership of the business and continues to play a central role in the business. The business has created at least 5 qualifying jobs and was able to raise at least $500,000. So what are some of the drawbacks of this program? So remember, the International Entrepreneur Parole Rule is just a parole. It's not a visa. So it's temporary and discretionary in nature. Every time those entrepreneurs moving around, every time something happens, they could potentially lose the parole. So that's kind of a little bit of a drawback. Another thing is that the parole does not make you eligible for a green card. So if you want to be able to stay permanently, you will have to apply for a green card through a different option. For example, you may qualify for the national interest waiver as an entrepreneur at the end of this 5-year period and therefore apply for a green card this way. But that particular program is not going to get you a green card even if you stay here for the full 5 years. How about family members? If you're married and you have a spouse and kids, they can come to the United States, your spouse can apply for a work permit and be able to work here while you're working on your startup inside the United States, and your children can go to school and enjoy all the benefits while you're in parole status. All in all, this is an amazing program that will help a lot of entrepreneurs that otherwise don't qualify for visas like the E2 or the EB2 green card or national interest waiver to get their opportunities to be able to build companies in the United States. And also, it's going to allow a lot of venture companies to draw in more entrepreneurs that otherwise wouldn't qualify for visas, just like people that are very young but have an idea and are able to attract opportunities and funding for the startups. Getting the parole will not only increase innovation in the United States, but it's also going to encourage people to come here, build companies, and be able to do so without worrying about a visa, whether they qualify or not, and being able to actually get those visas because they're stuck overseas and embassies are not willing to issue them those visas at the moment. So if you're interested to apply for the International Parole Program, make sure to text me. The number is right here, 619-483-4549. We have a lot of experience with entrepreneur visas and we're happy to offer that service to those of you that are watching this video or anybody else that is interested in this program. Once again, if you're here for the first time, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Click the notification bell so you don't miss any of our videos, and also give us a big like so YouTube will be able to share this video with more people just like you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next video.